This is a streamlined version of the previous video that I did for learning the Shurangama mantra, or brushing up on it if you've missing some lines or you're skipping lines. So this method is easier than the first video that's still available on my YouTube site. With this method, if you need a tablet. And you need the Kindle version of the recitation handbook. Now, if you don't have the Kindle version of the recitation handbook, which is excellent addition to your library, you could probably download the PDF on the website, the Dharma Realm Buddhist Association's website. So the method that I've been using lately, I find it really great, is to find your recorder on your digital device and then record yourself reciting the mantra. And whether you're doing the whole thing or a single thing, the process is the same. A few lines, the process is the same. You record what you want to record. Then you switch screens over to the book. Then you play the recording back and listen to it. Look at the book and see which lines you're missing while you're reciting along with the book. You'll see that the recording is either correct all the way through or it doesn't coincide with the book. So that makes it really simple. It's just a two-step process. The key is to understand that if you miss one or two lines anywhere in the mantra, it has a domino effect often, not always, but often, where you're going to be skipping a whole bunch of the subsequent lines before you get into a new section that you know. And you might be able to recite the whole thing pretty well, but miss a couple of lines here and there, and you'll wind up missing sections of the mantra. And that's what alerted me because I decided to record it one day to see how I was doing. If I was, it's been a while since I was checking myself. I found I was skipping sections, five lines here, 10 lines there. So the mantra is all integrated. All the parts work together. So if you're missing some here and there, it doesn't have the same efficacy. So then I decided to go back and relearn where I was falling short. And this is how I did it. And this streamlined method really works. So I'll go over it one more time. First, you record it. Record what you're doing. And next step is to, go to the next screen. Well, first push start, so that you're listening to your recording. Then go to the next screen and see how your recording matches with the actual text. And that will reveal which lines you're missing, of course. And then you go from there. So if you're just learning the mantra, this method is great because you just do sections at a time. In any case, you just do sections at a time on a long mantra like this. This is what the master always recommended. And that's actually how I learned it initially at Gold Mountain. I actually pinned it to my robe. I had it pinned to my robe. In 4x4 sheets, the whole mantra, and I would just all day long I would be reciting it until I learned the whole thing, and that included while I was washing dishes or sweeping floors, meditating, or whatever I was doing. I had it pinned to my robe, and I'd look at it as I was working, and that's how I learned it. And it took me a few months because I do not have a very good memory, so everybody is. Has to work on it their own way. But this is a good method, and it's the most streamlined that I have found, and it really works well. So, if you don't have the handbook, it's a good thing to have. Otherwise, you can download a PDF file on the website, City of 10,000 Buddhas website. If you poke around there, you'll see a book section, and I believe it's in there. Okay.